Somebody hold me too close. Somebody hurt me too deep. Somebody sit in my chair and ruin my sleep and make me aware of being alone.
Hello there, it's Michael from Red Chair Diaries coming to you from my red bedroom in Nova Scotia, Canada. And today I'm discussing a book. I borrowed it from the library. Isn't that wonderful? You can borrow ebooks. Deary, The Remarkable Life of Julia Child. Just finished it a few minutes ago. It's the third time I've borrowed it. I mean, it's taken me bits and pieces of reading. It's taken me about 4 or 5 weeks. I really, really, really enjoyed it. I am not a chef. I do very little cooking. I never watched any of her shows. She's had many series. And she died about 10 years ago, I guess, quite close to it. But for some reason, I became intrigued again about Julia Child. She's such an icon, at least in North America, for all of her cooking shows, for the impersonation that Dan Aykroyd did in the early years of Saturday Night Live, when he pretended he cut his finger off when he was portraying her. From the Swedish chef on The Muppets, that's based on Julia Child. She was the French chef. Heard that was the name of her show. And she had that sing-song voice and was really tall and was actually sometimes quite clumsy. And that's where that comes from, if you didn't know that. That's what the Swedish chef is all about, from the Sesame Street or The Muppets. I like a good biography, and I really thought this biography by Bob Spitz was very good. I think I saw a negative review of it on Amazon, so somebody was saying it wasn't that good, or it was derivative and all of that sort of stuff. What I liked about it is it is very, very anecdotal and just goes along like a steamroller. It just goes, and doesn't get terribly bogged down in a bunch of psychoanalysis, which I'd like when I'm reading a literary biography, but I just wanted to know what was going on in her life. And I've been intrigued about her more ever since I saw that movie, Julie and Julia, which was based on a woman called Julie who did a blog where she, I believe, was doing all the recipes in the Art of French Cooking, or Mastering the Art of French Cooking, actually, is the title. Or she was doing one per day for an entire year, if not all the recipes. And I enjoyed that movie where Julie was played by Amy Adams and Julia Child was played by Meryl Streep. And basically it was Julia Child's experiences in France in the late 1940s, early 50s, I guess it was. Maybe it was the early 50s. What I was intrigued about as well, though, is that when I had figured out from reading, I think, a review of this book a year ago, that Julia Child had been involved in the OSS during World War II. And the OSS is the predecessor for the CIA. So she was working in Ceylon, Sri Lanka now, processing reams of intelligence about World War II. That's when she was over there. So that was very interesting to me, because it's not something that would go to front of mind when you're watching The French Chef, that Julia Child had essentially been a spy, except that she wasn't out in the field, but she was an intelligence agent, in the office. And I really, really enjoyed that aspect. I just thought that was fantastic. She was about 6'3", 6'4", so she wasn't going to be out in the field playing a femme fatale or a Mata Hari type anyway, you know. But I was really anxious to get to that in the book. So the book, of course, starts with her birth, and she was actually from fairly well-to-do industrialist's family, and then takes you through her very bad performance in school because she was just such a rebel even at a young age. But she did end up going to Smith College, and getting never having high marks because she was that radical or rebel, but she did end up going to Washington, working for the government and all of that, and then working, out there in Asia. And she wanted to get posted when she met Paul Child. Her name was I think it's McWilliams. Yeah, I think it's McWilliams. And so she managed to get posted where he was, by default, not by machination. And eventually, the love affair did develop. And he was 10 years older than her, and they were together for 45 years. Anyway, the book, all about all the travails of trying to get the Mastering the Art of French Cooking made, because she was not a cook when she started. She did not come from a family of chefs or anything like that. She just became intrigued. She liked a good meal, and she thought she went was in Nirvana when she and Paul were in Paris and in France in general about the cooking. So she decided she had time in her hands because he was busy at the office. He was involved in sort of like the art part of trying to get the American message out after the war over there. And so she went into the Cordon Bleu School of Cooking, which was not a fancy place at all, as you may think. And it was full of a bunch of GIs. They're basically on a GI Bill, wanting to learn how to be cooks in restaurants more than being chefs. So all of that in the book is also very, very interesting, and that is portrayed in the movie. I think fairly realistically, compared, from what I read in here. One thing led to another, and she became friends with Simone Beck, and Simone Beck became her co-author. Then there was a third co-author who wasn't pulling her weight, and that's all detailed in this book. But there's still three names on the book, Mastering the Art of French Cooking, which really did become a classic. And I had no idea all the work that was involved in that. I mean, it went on, I think it was a decade before they got that book published, with false starts and so on. And I've just disappeared from the cover with all my moving around. There we go. Deary. And that's what she called everybody. She didn't bother learning everybody's names. So you had all of those activities, the pre-World War II, the World War II, the post-World War II life in Europe, and then Germany, and then Norway. She was posted, or they were posted to Oslo as well at one point. She said really complimentary things about Norway and the Norwegians. She really liked that. And eventually making their way back to the States and living in Cambridge, part of Boston, around Harvard or the area of Boston. I don't know if it's actually Boston. I guess it's not Boston, but it's adjacent. And then being offered, being tested out to do a little show at WGBH when it was still the National Educational Television. It was not even PBS, and they had no money, and she had to pay for her own ingredients and all of that. So I find the genesis of a television personality, that part of the biography, extremely interesting as well, about how you start with those baby steps and then things start snowballing. So I really enjoyed that. I enjoyed the book from beginning to end. Very easy to read, but man, on Goodreads, it says it's a 1,000-page book. It's not a 1,000-page book. There's no way. If you go on Amazon.ca, it says, I think 576 pages, something like that. And there's large parts of that at the back are references. I think it's probably about 500 pages of reading, but since I read it as a borrowed ebook from the library, I don't even know how big the typeface or anything is. But I must say that I really enjoyed it. It's coming out in paperback, I think a trade paperback next month. I'd like to get it as a remainder. I don't want to buy it as as an expensive hardcover. If I see it in the next year for $10 in the local chapters here in Canada, I'll pick it up and put it in my biography section because I read a lot of them. Anyway, Really enjoyed it. I want to share that with you. You don't have to cook to enjoy it, but I did go on YouTube yesterday and I did look up some of her old recipes from her early shows, and she did. Her instructions were marvelous as to how to get things done. I said to Ted, "Oh my God, I think I can make an omelet that'll work probably." And I said, "Maybe I should make French onion soup." I became all enthusiastic. Hopefully that'll wear off before the day's out. Anyway, Dairy, biography of Julia Child, and I am going to pick up that Julie and Julian as a budget disc and keep that in my library. I'd like to see that again. And something that you may find extremely ironic and amusing in this is that this book, I think, was written before, or it doesn't allude to that movie, so I don't. That movie came out before this book was published, I think, and this book was published officially, I think, last, like, I think it was last August or September, if you check it on the net. And Julie and Julia must have been 2010 or 2011. It doesn't reference it, but it does reference that Julia Child was annoyed at Meryl Streep. It had nothing to do with the movie because the movie came out after Julia Child was dead. But annoyed because of her campaign, and I remember that from over 20 years ago about some kind of insecticide, I think, LAR, something like that, on apples. And I remember when Meryl Streep was getting a lot of publicity about finding fault with this coating that was on apples. And I think that she was Meryl Streep was actually found to be correct later on, according to a note in this book, but it doesn't say anything about the movie that she was in portraying Julia Child. So I thought that was interesting. Julia took great exception at people finding fault with her for liking veal and eating a lot of butter and drinking a lot of wine. Anyway, Dairy, the biography of Julia Child, very entertaining. And from the Red Chair Library, essentially, this is Michael from Red Chair Diaries in Canada, and I'll see you around the tube.